Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the College of Physicians for the launch of the Fine Gael Manifesto. Members of our front bench have travelled from their various constituencies to be here for this launch. This manifesto sets out clearly the political intentions of the Fine Gael party if elected to government. It is a collection of common sense and credible, achievable proposals. Proposals that have been in the making for quite some time. Proposals that are designed above all to achieve the common good. They are based on having listened to the voices of Ireland and our view of how politics can change the direction of our country for the better. This manifesto is a way to bring the values of the Irish people back into Ireland's public life. It is a way for people to see their standards, their hopes, their ideals shared by and cherished by and acted upon by their government. It is an important document in making government part of the people and people understanding that they own the government. In a democracy, that is not just desirable, it is absolutely fundamental. And that's been denied to our people for a very long time. Because what Fianna Fáil have done in government, in abdicating its responsibility to leave Ireland at the mercy of the developers, the bankers and our supposed watchdogs, is not just immoral, it is amoral. And with this manifesto, I say no more. Yes, our people are angry. They're raw, disgusted, more than anxious even, some fearful. These people are our neighbours, our friends, who've lost their jobs, people who are sick to their stomachs at the thought of losing their homes. Women knowing the agony of neither having the money nor the means to pay bills and meet repayments. They're the parents who know a new set of numbers to add to the millions and the billions that they hear on a daily basis. It's a six-digit number, 001604. It's the code for Vancouver. They're the small business people who are slaughtered because there is no credit available to enable them to continue their life streams and their business. That anger, just and proper as it is, will not get this country working. Fine Gael's manifesto, Let's Get Ireland Working, will get our country working. So what's possible? What can be done? What's achievable? These are the questions that people ask politicians. What are you going to do? Tell me your programme. Outline your plan. We recognise in Fine Gael that because jobs and opportunities are the best chance of keeping our best asset, our young people at home, that's been a central focus of this programme. We plan to create 100,000 new jobs over the next 5 years by our 7 billion investment in the New Era programme from the Pension Reserve Fund and the sale of non-strategic assets in the area of water, communications and renewables. We plan to put together 45,000 training and second start education proposals over the next number of years. We will cut employers' PRSI by 50%. We'll lower the VAT rate from 13.5% to 12% on labour-intensive services like restaurants or hairdressing and builders. We'll support Ireland's small and medium enterprises by reducing the costs imposed on them by the state. It should be noted that when Micheál Martin was Minister for Enterprise, Ireland's competitiveness slipped by 20 points on that ladder. In stark contrast, I want to make this country the best small country in the world in which to do business by 2016. That's a fitting date and an achievable target. Second major point of our 5-point plan is that we will fix Ireland's budget deficit by prioritising an end to waste and we'll do that instead of raising taxes. High taxes, as we know, kill jobs. So we will keep taxes down, particularly income taxes, in which we've given a specific commitment. Fine Gael is the only party in this election, the only party with a costed and credible plan to reduce that deficit. Other parties may want to delay deficit reduction, to raise taxes. But that is not reasonable. We can't delay, because delay is too dangerous. It increases uncertainty, and it kills that early chance for the economy to recover. One thing is sure, we cannot and will not fix our finances by continuing a policy of writing blank cheques, irrespective of circumstances, for banks. It is ruinous, it's heartbreaking for our people, and as I've said already, it is amoral. I told Chancellor Merkel in Berlin yesterday that the IMF-EU deal, in our view, needs to be renegotiated. It was a bad deal for Ireland, and indeed a bad deal for Europe. Unless its terms are changed, it can push us over the edge. We will continue to build cooperation at European level, in that in the event of the people electing this party to government, we have already signalled clearly what our priorities will be in terms of our view of renegotiation with European support and consent. Ireland is overspending over $18 billion on health. It's a system that hasn't worked. It's a system created by Micheál Martin that has not delivered for our people. It needs to be radically transformed, and our view, as you know, is to introduce the system based on the Dutch model of health, which is the number one in Europe. Our Fair Care plan, outlined by Deputy Leader Dr. Riley, will cut waiting lists and end the apartheid in our health system. With universal health insurance, everybody will have equal access. There will be more and better community care. There will be fewer hospital stays. There will be fewer hospital patients. And that means that lower hospital costs are better for the taxpayer and indeed for the patient. Fourth point of our plan is to deal with smaller and better government, with the people's money being spent wisely on vital public services. By streamlining systems, by cutting red tape, by abolishing quangos, we will reduce public service costs by €5 billion. If this is not done, and it's already been signed off by government, that the IMF will look at the question of numbers and public pay. We oppose this. We want to defend public salaries. I've made our position on this very clear. We've set out our view in respect specifically of income tax. We will get efficiency. Yes, we will. But equally, we will protect the frontline essential services that are being delivered by so many public servants and people in essential service delivery across the country. Sweden did this. Canada did this. And in our view, it is eminently achievable to have a saving of 1 in 10 in public service expenditure at the moment. The fifth and last point deals with the politics of Ireland and the political system. I'm not sure whether it is just by coincidence that the Fianna Fáil document produced recently seems to be replicated in part by a draft produced from Dermot Desmond and a range of other views from people in outside political life. I don't object to anybody giving their views about how politics should be run, but I have one essential fundamental to me, and that is if people are being asked to accept responsibility in politics, in my view, they have to be elected. That is fundamental in a democracy like this, and what's happened in our system is that it has not been let work, it's been let run down deliberately by governments who did not want to have accountability or responsibility placed on their shoulders and be seen to be by the people where it counts. We will start by cutting the number of politicians by a third. We will impose a ceiling on higher public service salaries, including for the office of the Taoiseach and for ministers appointed to government. We will end the severance payments. We will introduce carpooling. We will ensure proper accountability for decisions. These are important perceptions and important elements of fact that people can see that politics under Fine Gael, political decisions under Fine Gael, will be seen to take their share of sorting out this country's problems. Today, I understand, is the anniversary of the birth of Galileo. He said one time, measure what is measurable, make measurable what is not. Good advice for any incoming government. A single chamber parliamentary system with really powerful Dáil committees will hold ministers and government and public to account indeed. We will ban the corporate donations. We'll involve people in the process of political change. Make them feel that the government is theirs and that the government is there to serve and that it's part of them. And the chasm that I've spoken of on many occasions is now so wide in Irish politics, in Irish life. The chasm, the cynicism that's there because politics and the political system has drifted from hundreds of thousands of people. As I've said before, it's necessary to put that arm of political democracy around the shoulders of people who feel uncomfortable, who feel disenfranchised, who feel distant, who feel that their country doesn't bear any relevance for them anymore. I want to introduce a system that makes people proud, proud of government. We're proud of our country, and that together as a people, we can repair our damaged reputation, rebuild our standing, both nationally and internationally. It's not going to be that difficult to do that, because the Irish, as a race, have that inherent capacity to connect in a way that few others have ever been able to show. So accountability and sacrifice begins at the centre and at the top. If the people on the 25th of February decide to support the Fine Gael party in large numbers, which is what my request of them would be, we will replace old government indifference with new government insight. We will replace the old dysfunction and the disorder at the heart of government with a government, indeed, that holds the hearts of the people in their own. A government that they can trust, a government that they can believe in, a government that is open to them, a government that is a Fine Gael government. Essential to this campaign has been the fact that the five-point plan set out by our party is interlinked, and it deals with the fundamental problems, the structural problems, the broken systems, and the capacity to repair these, deal with our financial problems, restore confidence, keep interest rates down, keep taxes down, get jobs growing, get confidence back into our economy, get our country working. As we pointed out before, this country is not banjaxed, far from it. We've overcome adversity in the past, we will overcome the challenges that now face us. But we'll do it in a way that's planned, that's constructive, that's credible, and that's achievable. I believe, after having fought, I think it's 12 elections, that in this occasion, this is the best plan that any party's ever had, that within the constraints of the IMF-EU deal is achievable, is credible, and that will transform our country. I also believe that the team of people that surround me, the team of people that the Fine Gael party have, is the best to deliver on this plan. A team of competent, professional, efficient people who can be trusted in their politics to deliver on what we say we'll do. From that perspective, I look forward to the remainder of this campaign. To your questions in respect of our programme, we've got numbers of front bench members here and others who can't fit at the top table to answer any specific questions relevant to their areas of responsibility that you might want to ask. Thank you for your indulgence.